I now hand the conference over to Mr. Sumant Kumar from Motilal Oswal Financial Services. Thank you, and over to you, sir.
Thank you, everyone. Good afternoon, everyone, and very warm welcome to Apollo Pipes Q4 FY21 post-sale earnings call hosted by Motilal Oswal Financial Services. On the call today, we have Apollo Pipes management team being represented by Mr. Sameer Gupta, MD, Mr. Ajay Kumar Chan, CFO, and Mr. Anubhav Gupta, CSO. We will begin the call with the key thoughts from the management team. Thereafter, we will open the floor for Q&A session. I would now like to request the management to share their perspective on the performance of the company. Thank you, and over to you, Mr. Sameer.
Thank you, sir. Good afternoon, everyone, and thank you for joining us on the Q4 FY21 earnings call to discuss the operating and financial performance for the quarter. I trust that you and your families are safe. I hope you all had the opportunity to go through our financial result presentation, which provides details of our operational and financial performance for the fourth quarter and full year ended 31st March 2021. To begin with, I am pleased to share with you that we have reported a robust performance during the quarter, with our sales volume growing by 34% to 12987 metric tons. Volume growth was driven by our healthy contribution from the CPVC, UPVC pipe and value-added product segment of fittings. Furthermore, expansion of product portfolio improved reach in newer geographies and addition of new brownfield capacity assisted volume growth. Over the next few quarters, we anticipate this sales performance trend to strengthen, led by improving demand environment, expansion in addressable markets and a sustainable uptick in utilization levels. Moving on the operational front, we have successfully completed all our brownfield manufacturing expansions across facilities located at Dadri, Tumkur and Secunderabad. The operationalization of our greenfield facility at Raipur, which would have an installed capacity of 7,200 metric tons per annum, is delayed due to the impact of second wave of COVID. However, we expect to commercialize this facility in the current month only. So in all, with the addition of new capacities, we will be able to notably scale our volumes in the coming quarters. In addition, we are aiming optimally utilization our capacities over the next 2 years, which will also help augment sales volume going ahead. From a product basket standpoint, we continue to witness a positive traction in inquiries of Apollo Life's water storage tanks. Earlier in the previous quarter, we had doubled our capacity for this product at our Secunderabad plant and also commissioned a production line in Tumkur to ensure that we can meet the increased demand. We remain confident that this product, along with our other value offerings like fittings, solvent sealants, bar fittings, adhesive steps, will enhance our reach and strengthen sales and going forward. To conclude, I would like to state that we are constantly working towards enhancing our presence across existing and new potential geographies. Once we complete the operationalization of our plant, we expect to address the untapped and high potential market of Central and Eastern India as well. Going forward, we expect to deliver a robust performance in the quarters to come and further gain the momentum on the back of improved profitability, strategic expansion in key geographical areas and better brand acceptance. On that note, I would now like to invite Mr. Ajay Jain to run you through the key financial highlights for the quarter and full year ended 31st March 2020. Mr. Jain, please.
Yes. Good afternoon, everyone. I will briefly cover the financial performance during the quarter and full year ended March 31st, 2021. The company delivered a strong operational and financial performance during the quarter, driven by an uptick in demand and consumption in key domestic markets. Revenue from operations for the quarter stood at 174.2 crores as against 94.1 crore in Q4 FY20, higher by 85%. In financial year FY21, full year revenue from operations stood at 518.1 crores as against 408 crores, up by 27%. Sales volume for the quarter stood at 12,987 metric tons, growing by 34% as against 9,721 metric tons per annum. Sales volume for financial year FY21 stood at 47,333 metric tons per annum, as against 44,692 metric tons, up by 6%. despite operating for only around 10 months in the last year. On the profitability front, EBITDA for the quarter grew by 158%, which stood at 27 crores as against 10.5 crores in Q4 FY20. EBITDA margin, which stood at 16% in Q4 FY21 as against 11% in Q4 FY20, higher by 439 bps. EBITDA for FY21 stood at 74.3 crores as against rupees 46.4 crores, growing by 60%. EBITDA margin for the full year ended March 31st, 2021 stood at 14% when compared to 11% in the corresponding period last year, higher by 297 bps. Going forward, we anticipate EBITDA margin to normalize. During the quarter, we witnessed a sharp increase in depreciation during the quarter, which was partially offset by a reduction in financial cost. Depreciation cost stood at 5.8 crores in Q4 FY21 as against rupees 3.7 crores in FY20, growing by 57%. PAT for the quarter stood at 16.6 crores, up by 169% when compared to rupees 6.2 crores in Q4 FY20. PAT margins for the quarter stood at 9% as compared to 6% in Q4 FY20, higher by 302 bps. PAT for FY21 also grew by 56%, stood at 44.5 crores as against 28.5 crores in FY20. PAT margins during the period stood at 8% as compared to 7% in FY20, higher by 162 bps. On the balance sheet front, our net cash position stood healthy at 10 crores. On the working capital front, additional raw material requirements at newly commissioned capacities may moderately impact inventory levels in the near term. However, our endeavor remains on maintaining our overall working capital cycle at stable levels. With this, I would now request the moderator to open the forum for any questions or suggestions that you may have. Thank you.
Thank you very much. We will now begin the question and answer session. Anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one on their touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star and two. Participants are requested to use handsets while asking a question. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. Reminder to the participants, anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one at this time. The first question is from the line of Arpit Shah from Anvil Asset Advisors. Please go ahead.
Hi, I'm Yoram from Stallion Asset. I just had a couple of questions. Under the cash flow statement, can you help me with what is the positive 22 crores coming from capital work in progress?
Ankit, your voice is not clear. Please repeat again.
Yeah, under the cash flow statement, we are seeing a positive 22 crores coming from capital work in progress. Can you help me with that? What is that?
See, actually, the 22 crores, that was the opening WIP which got adjusted in after capitalization on my fixed assets.
Capital work in progress last year was 30 crores and this year is 7.7 crores.
So that's what I'm saying. 22 crores WIP got capitalized in my fixed assets.
Okay, got it. And can you help me with the capacity of water tanks?
Currently, it is 3,600 tons, but after this fourth capacity at Raipur, it would be 4,800 tons.
And what is the revenue potential, let's say, in the next 2-3 years?
Revenue potential for water tanks?
Yeah.
Yeah, of course, we foresee revenue to be roughly around 60 crores by the end of the financial years, FY23.
FY23? Hello?
Yeah, FY23, next 2 years.
Okay. The kind of pressure that you're seeing in the raw materials, is it continuing even in the month of April?
No, the pressure has been released. The prices are softening up. So we don't see any prices, you can say, jacking up in the current quarter. Rather, it should go down in the coming months.
Okay, and any impact on demand in the last 15 days?
Yeah, of course, because of lockdown, the demand has been impacted because all across the India, many markets have been shut down and strict lockdowns have been followed up in many states. So the demand has been impacted in the last 15 days, 10 days or 15 days, it has been impacted.
Okay. Thank you,
sir. Thank you. The next question is from the line of Bhargav Buddhadev from Kotak Mutual Fund. Please go ahead.
Yeah, good afternoon, team, and congrats for a good performance.
Thank you, Mr.
Bhargav. My first question is on volume growth. Is it possible to share volume growth in agri and non-agri in the fourth quarter and maybe in FY21?
So volume growth, if you talk about agri, it was a bit affected because of the very high resin prices. But if we talk about the building products, the volume growth was good. And you can say that we foresee that the volume growth will continue, you can say, in the coming quarters for that building product, because we have completed our product basket. The lot of fittings we have added, and a lot of new, you can say, product range has also been added in the fitting segment. So that is driving the demand in that segment. Other than that, there is good demand in overall, you can say, from each and every sector.
So was there growth on the agri portfolio in the fourth quarter?
Yeah, of course. There was growth, but not to that extent. The growth was there, of course.
Okay. Secondly, is it possible to share what is the installed capacity across all your plants as on 31st March and what are the utilization levels across plants?
Across the plants, we have total capacity of 118,000 tons, which we have already shared. But due to this price sensitivity, we cannot this competition. We cannot disclose this thing on the Instagram. We can share the details with you on the email.
Okay. On the cash conversion cycle, our cash cycle is at about 65 days versus say 30 days for larger players. But as we sort of inch closer to our target of about 1,000 crore revenue, do you expect material improvement in the cash conversion cycle as well?
Of course, it will improve because we have been ramping up the sales. Because of that thing, this working capital cycle has been gone up. But if you see the quarter-wise, it is not increased to that level. By quarter end, if you see just by quarter to quarter, because of the high sales in the last quarter, you can see the inventory level or the debtors has gone up. Otherwise, it is very much in control.
On our domestic sourcing of PVC, where we are in terms of percentage?
Earlier to this quarter, we were mainly sourcing our raw materials from imports market. But from the last quarter, we have changed our strategy to source mainly from the domestic players, such as domestic producers in India or the traders who are selling the products. So we have changed our strategy a little bit for the short term to source our raw material from the local sources in the coming future.
And lastly, on CAPEX, what would be the guidance for next 2 years?
CAPEX will be very moderate in the coming years because we have done the maximum of the CAPEX and now it is time to ramp up the sales to increase the utilization level of all the capacities that are available with us. So we are much more, you can say, focused towards capacity utilization. Maintenance CAPEX or some small CAPEX will be there, which will be somewhere around 20 to 25% of the EBITDA.
So about 20-25 odd crores per year, is that fair number?
Somewhere should be around that only.
Okay, I'll come back in the queue and all the very best.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Ashish Bodar from Anand Rathi. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi. So extending Bhargav's question, if you can share the mix of volumes which you did in FY21 across the three segments, which is agri, plumbing and sewage.
Agri and this building segments, they share roughly, earlier it was somewhere around 60% and 40%, but now it has improved to almost 50% of agriculture business and balance 50% is coming from building products. And we are much more focused towards building products as we have told in the earlier calls also. So we are much more increasing the capacities or marketing activities towards this product only because of the better EBITDA margin as compared to agriculture products.
Okay, so on the margin profile, is this the higher mix of agri product impacting your overall margin profile? Because if I compare your margin profile with the other larger peers, I see large difference. So is it because of the product mix and of course the low utilization level also? So are these the two factors, or is they, are there any other factor also?
Low utilization level is not impacting us on any of the costing factor. So that margins are not affected because of the low utilization level. But of course, we are focusing on that product mix. Of course, that is making a difference for the, you can say that better, you can say better margin in the coming quarters, because we are much more focused towards this building products. Of course, the other players, they are very old and they are quite strong in those products, and we have recently entered, and on 4-5 years back only, we have entered into this product. So we see that in the coming years, we will see a better, you can say, utilization level and the better profit margins in these products because of, you can say, better higher ratio of building products in the total sales.
So any target set internally for FY23 or 24 about the mix and the margin target? Any color on that?
Of course, we target to sell around 60-65% of the building products by the end of FY23, and we are much more focused on that thing only.
Okay, sir, got it, sir. Thank you so much, and all the best.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Sneha Talreja from Edelweiss Securities. Please go ahead.
Oh, congratulations on great set of numbers, sir. My question is more pertaining to your margins. Is there what is the kind of inventory gain that we've seen during the quarter and during the year?
Because inventory gain, we cannot establish what exactly it was, because it's a moving average and it is not very easy to calculate the inventory gain. Of course, it was there in the quarter three, but in quarter four, it is not very big number. Which was almost all the increases have been there since the start of January month. So there is not too much inventory gain in the fourth quarter. Of course, because of that, you can say better this product mix, the margin was there. Other than that, the inventory gain was not too much in that fourth quarter.
So the reason for margin dip on a QOQ basis could be only because the inventory gains were missing this particular quarter compared to the last quarter?
There were two reasons, not exactly only the inventory gain was there. First of all, of course, the inventory gain was there in the quarter three. Of course, other than that, the operational issues was also there. So because of that, unorganized players or small players, they were facing difficulties to operate in the quarter three because of the restrictions from government. So that was giving us a benefit in selling our product at a better margin as compared to Q4, where the things were much more normalized as compared to Q3. So put together, the margins effect was there.
I mean, could you elaborate that issue that you mean to say that the smaller players were facing issue in Q3 but not in Q4? And what was the reason they were facing issue according to you?
Because of the lockdowns continuing in Q3, many restrictions were still there in Q3. Whereas the Q4, almost all everything was normalized and operations were very much normalized. So because of those things, the smaller players or unorganized players, they were facing problem in operating in Q3.
Okay.
Anupam here. So just to add on this point, like in all the building material industries in quarter 3, whether it was PVC pipes or structural steel tubes or tiles, etc., the unorganized and smaller players, they were pretty much not able to start organized. So in all the industries, what we saw was the gain fell in laps of branded large organized players. And that's why all the companies could report very strong numbers in Q3 in terms of sales volume increase, right? So as these things started improving, so overall industry also started to improve participation from the smaller guys.
So sorry,
and
breaking from your line, sir.
Sorry, can you hear me now?
Yes.
Yes, better.
Yeah. The participation from amazing smaller players also started to improve, and the premium, the demand pool which was there in Q3 slightly got away. So
okay, Anubhav, I'm really sorry, but was not able to hear you properly. We'll again connect with you at a later stage about this. If my second question was actually relating to the demand in case of sir can answer that. Basically, how much is the dip we would have seen April versus a normal April or April versus quarter four? This is just to, you know, get a sense that how much demand would have been down given the current lockdowns which are in place. So some quantitative statement there.
No, you want to understand about April 20 or April 21?
April 21, given we have seen, you know, sudden again lockdowns coming up. Just want to see the impact which it will have on the Q1 numbers.
Q1 numbers, because things are not yet clear, the lockdowns are going on. April numbers were moderately okay because the first half was totally okay. There were no restrictions. In the later half, the restrictions started coming in several states. So the numbers we are not able to right now clarify because the things are not clear, because how the lockdown will move and how the government will take step in terms of controlling the situation. So as the things will be more clear, we can let you know regarding the exact numbers that we expect in the Q1.
Sure. Just last one from mine. Are you seeing some kind of a pickup starting for agri segment, or it still continues to remain weak given that, you know, prices are still at elevated level, or because we are coming to closer to the season, have you started seeing any kind of pickup there?
No, I could not understand what exactly was your question. You want to know what exactly was the impact of the prices on agri pipes?
Agri pipes. Have you started seeing any kind of a pickup there because we are coming closer to the season?
Yeah, of course, the agri pipe demand should be there, but because of lockdown continuing all across the country, many states have strict lockdown and some have partial lockdowns. So there has been an impact on the demand, a big impact on the demand because of the lockdowns. So we cannot right now say that what exactly will be the demand if the market is open and how the farmers will behave with the current prices. But of course, if the market opens, then the demand will be there. Even the prices are higher or lower, they will definitely buy pipes.
Sure. Thanks, sir. And all the very best.
Thank you.
The next question is from the line of Yash from ICICI. Please go ahead.
Yeah, good afternoon, sir. Congratulations on a great set of numbers. Just wanted to check with you. We've been increasing our margins by introducing new products. One product that I was seeing quite interesting, looked interesting, you started manufacturing steel sinks. So while the margin profile would improve, but probably this is our first product which is not into the plastic category. So wanted to understand from you, what is our outlook towards more and more new products? Are we shifting more towards the building material kind of company? That is my first question. And my second question is relating to your ESOP policy. How do you see the ESOP policy going forward? So we've seen Apollo Pipes Trust buying shares from the secondary market and giving ESOPs to employees. So what is your outlook on the ESOP policy of the company? Thank you so much.
Yeah, regarding first of all the steel things that we talk about, it is a trading item. We are not manufacturing steel things at any of our units. We are trading it, and actually it is an allied product with the bath fittings that we are already selling in various markets. We are manufacturing bath fittings at our Dadri location. So this is the by-product, you can say, or the additional product which is being sold at the same market or same counters where we sell the bath fittings. So steel things, of course, we are marketing this product, but it is right now not a focus product for us. It is a, you can say, added product in the product. Core basket of bath fittings. Secondly, if you talk about ESOP, right now we have distributed the shares that we have bought in the last quarter, the shares to the employees, and around 1 lakh shares we have purchased from the market, and out of that around 91,000 shares has been allocated to the employees of Apollo Pipes. So right now we are continuing with this policy only, and we have no plan right now for the next ESOP policy. As the things will move forward, we will plan and see that what best we can do in the ESOP, because it is a good, you can say, good thing to boost up the, you can say, this morale of employees, and we see that it should give us good results.
Thank you so much, sir. All the best.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Behzad Kalantri from Stallion Asset. Please go ahead. Behzad Kalantri, your line is in talk mode. Please go ahead with your question.
Yeah, hi, sir. Good morning. Great set of numbers. Congratulations. Just one question I had is, I just wanted to understand the long-term vision of the company. You guys, you know, have started coming up with new products, and that's great. So I just wanted to understand from your point of view, are you planning to increase market share in the pie, or are you trying to expand the whole pie at the end of the day? That's broadly just what I wanted to ask.
We right now wish to increase the, you can say, market share, and we are much more focused towards testing only. Of course, the market is very big, and right now, if you see the potential of the market, we see good opportunities, and of course the lack of, you can say, branded players in the market, and we have Apollo is a strong brand in building products. So we look good opportunities, and we get, you can say, better acceptance level in the market. So right now we are much more focused towards increasing the, you can share, our market share in the market.
Okay, and is there any chance, like, you guys are planning to increase the pie of the market also at the end of the day?
Of course we can do that, but right now we are not in that big, you can say, numbers that we increase the pie of the market, because in that case we need to develop new and newer products, applications, and we need to increase our R&D team. So right now we are not into that mode. We are much more focused to increase the market share.
Got it. Thank you, and all the very best. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Ashish Kacholia from Lucky Investment Managers. Please go ahead.
Yeah. Good morning to the Apollo Pipes team. My question is basically, can you talk a little bit about your brand building efforts? Because we are a challenger brand in the market. So what are the brand building efforts that we are taking? That is one. And the second thing is, which are our key target markets that we are looking to develop over the next 3 to 5 years?
Yeah. Good morning, sir. Yeah, regarding the brand building activities, we are tying up some celebrities with our brand. Apart from Mr. Amitabh Bachchan, who is associated with steel brand, we are tying some brands, brand ambassadors for the plastic pipe only. So this was due in the current quarter only, but because of the lockdown, it was a bit delayed, and we hope to close the shoots by the end of, you can say, June, when the lockdown opens. So we are into that activity, and we are seeing that we should expand around 2 to 3% minimum of the revenue in branding of the activities, which will be mainly coming from ATL activities such as TVCs and other hoardings, outdoor hoardings. So we are, focusing in a big scale for the brand building activities in this current year. And what was this key target market?
Which are your key target geographies over the next 3 to 5 years?
Key target markets, of course, we are targeting in an aggressive way for the southern market, and we are getting good response from those markets. We have increased our sales team in the southern market in all the 6 states, whether it is Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Kerala, Andhra, and Telangana. We have much more focus in those areas because it is a big market, and we have got a big, good brand presence over there. Apart from that, we are also trying to capture the untapped market of the eastern region, where we were not present earlier, and the market share was very low of Apollo over there. So we are trying to capture those market also, because we will be having the rapid unit by the end of this month. So we will be cost effective in many products, and we see that the market potential is there. And the lack of big brands is there in the eastern region. So we can capture those market also. So apart from northern region, we are trying to capture the southern region and the eastern region, to increase the sales of Apollo.
So let's focus on the western market. Is that correct?
Yeah, of course, we are focusing on the western. Let's focus on the western market for timing only, because this Ahmedabad unit is quite small as compared to the Tumkur unit or the, you can say, this Dadri unit. So we are focusing on those markets, but it is less focused as compared to other markets.
Okay, and what is our selling proposition versus the larger brands for the customer? Is it price, or is it service, or is it something?
We have to keep actually all the things together. It has to be price also. Along with that, aggression has also to be there, and the service, of course, it has to be there. So we are targeting all the three services, key factors to support the, you can say, retailers or the distributors of Apollo, so that they can increase the market share in their respective areas. So we are trying to focus on these 3 points where we can support them. of course, that we are not trying to leverage any credit, extended credit facilities to them, because we are trying to keep ourselves very strict in the credit policy. Apart from that, we are trying to help them in every point.
Okay, and my last question is basically, how does our product quality compare with the quality of the leaders?
It is, sir, it is at par with all the, you can say, all the manufacturers that we are talking about. So we are not compromising any sort of, you can say, any sort of quality compromise is not there in any of our products. They are at par with any of the, you can say, brand that we talk about.
So basically, once the customer buys our product, the experience will be the same, whatever he would have bought.
Of course, it will be the same as compared to the other products.
Great. Thank you very much and all the very best. Yeah.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Madhav Marda from Fidelity Investments. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi sir. Good afternoon. Thank you so much for your time. I wanted to firstly just get any thoughts on, you know, government announced a big spending on Jal Jeevan, etc. A lot of projects for pipe water supply. Have we seen any initial traction on the ground so far? Has there anything been moving, or it is still slow? In the last couple of months.
These things were actually earlier, it was on the tendering stage in the, by Q3, it was on the tendering stage. And the government has been started, you can say, allocating these tenders to the contractors. And now the contractors are in market for buying these products. Of course, the demand is there. But because of the very high prices, the sustainability with the contractors was not there. So they were trying to, you can say, a bit compromise on the quality, which Apollo was not into that. So we have to, we can say, wait a little bit for because of that high resin prices or high polymer prices. But right now, as the prices are softening up and as the market for opening, so the demands were there, and we see that there should be good demand on this account. And of course, the tenders has been allocated to the contractors, and they are buying the products from the market. And we are supplying to them, but it is not up to that level because of the high prices. They are much more focused towards the prices instead of quality.
Okay. But in these kind of tenders, there's no specification which happens, is it? Like they specify 4-5 brands and then they buy from them, or anyone?
No, sir. It is not like that. There is no such specified brand in any of these tenders.
Okay. Yeah, I guess that's my only question. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Dhiral Shah from PhillipCapital. Please go ahead.
Yeah, good afternoon, sir, and thanks for the opportunity. So in last 1 year, sir, we have increased our capacity by almost 50,000 tons, from 75,000 to now almost 125,000. So if you can share the detail, you know, the segment-wise capacity increment we have done in last 1 year, so how much in PVC, CPV, solids and fittings?
Sir, mainly the capacity expansions were mainly in the fitting segment, because we were running short of capacities in the fitting segment, and the product range was very big. So we were not able to supply the full product despite the molds available with us. So the major capacity expansion is in fittings. Apart from that, the capacity expansion is, of course, there in CPVC. Along with that, PVC pipe, minimum capacity expansion is there. But mainly capacity expansion is in CPVC pipes and fitting segment.
And sir, how much would be the proportion for this two?
It should be around 50% capacity addition. 50 to 60% capacity addition is there in fittings. And our same capacity addition is in CPVC pipe also.
Okay. And sir, in terms of retail touch point, how much we have added in last 1 year, and particularly in West and Southern region?
Of course, we are trying very hard to increase the touch points of the retail on the retail sector, and we have increased, you can say, somewhere around 1,000 to 1,500 touch points minimum in the southern sector. But right now, the exact numbers are not there with us. We can share you later on.
Okay, sure. And sir, lastly, what is your volume guidance for next 1 to 3 years, or any targeted capacity utilization for next 1 to 2 years?
We are trying to increase the capacity utilization up to the percentage of 80% by the end of 2 years. So we are trying to increase the, you can say, capacity utilization by increasing the sales of the segments where we are not able to sell. So some of the segments are being overloaded, and some of the segments we are trying to sell hard because of the market conditions. So by the end of 2 years, we are trying to increase the capacity utilization up to around 80%. But of course, that is, you can say, again, should be, you can say, it's a 2 years down the line we are talking about. So let's see how we can move.
Okay, so of the 1,25,000, you are looking at 80% utilization by FY23 end.
Yeah, 1 lakh tons. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you so much. That's it from my side.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Kushal Jajodia from Kushal Jajodia and Associates. Please go ahead.
Good morning, everyone. So my question is that during the COVID period, how many dealers have been increased during the period of year in FY21, and how do we forecast in FY22?
The dealers around 10 to 15% numbers of dealers has been added, and we are continuously working on the increasing of, you can say, dealers or the retailers. So right now we are not able to, you can say, tell you the exact numbers. That of course it will be minimum 10 to 20% of the dealer addition will be there, and 25 to 30% of the retail touch points will be there.
Okay, sir. So my second question is, since we are a part of the famous Apollo Group, so the building segment of the other group companies like Tricot or APL Steel Tech, is that helping in the increase of dealers in Apollo Piping System?
Of course, we definitely get an edge because of being a part of Apollo Group. The dealers give the, you can say, brand the respect that we have, and we definitely get an, you can say, get an support in selling the products in the dealer network. So that is definitely the support is definitely there, and we get a you can say support in marketing our product because of the Apollo Steel brand.
Sir, I have just one last question. So we are forecasting a good revenue growth. Personally, I'm expecting 800 crores in the next year. So how do we see a future aspect in a turnaround of the business vision or something in the next 3 to 5 years?
We are, Mr. Kushal, we are actually, first of all, we are trying to increase the utilization level, which will, of course, if we increase the utilization level, it will definitely support in increasing the, you can say, top numbers to around 700 or 800 CR that we are expecting. But of course, down the years, 3 years or 5 years, once we achieve this target, we will definitely aim higher figures, and we will try to increase these numbers to, you can say, next, you can say, around 30 to 40% at least growth in the coming years. But again, as we move forward, the things by seeing the things, how things are moving, we will take the step and try to maximize the sales and maximize the profit.
Thank you so much, sir. Happy growth.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Ashil from CJ Shah and Company. Please go ahead.
Hi, sir. I had a couple of questions. One was, you said that the building product side gives you better margins as compared to the agri side. Can you provide some numbers as to that? And secondly, is the margin differential due to product mix, or is it the same products you all can get a better margin?
Of course, building products get a higher margin as compared to agriculture products. In agriculture products, the EBITDA margin runs from around, you can say, around 7 to 12%, 7 to 10%, depending on market to market. Whereas building products, they fetch the margin of around 15 to 20% on average basis. So we are definitely, because of those reasons, we are trying to increase the market share of this product, building products, in our product portfolio. And what exactly was your second question? Product mix. Yeah, of course, we are targeting to have, you can say, good product share of building products in our product mix. And we are working on that front only. So going forward, you can say the product mix will be getting better by increasing numbers of building products as compared to agriculture products.
Got it. And so you also mentioned that you're planning to hit of the 1,25,000 ton around 80% capacity utilization in the next 2 years. That would mean that you would have to hit some sort of 40-45% volume growth. Is there any plan behind how you would aim to achieve that?
Of course, there is no such you can say rocket science for achieving those things. We have to work hard in the markets regarding the brand building, regarding the product distribution or the retail or the touch points increasing. We are working on that front only, and we the brand is quite good, I can say, and it is visible all across the India because of the very you can say big steel brand that is we are working with. So that should not be a very big, you can say, challenge for us, seeing the brand visibility and the brand presence across the India for the you can say steel brand. So further, we are mainly working with that, you can say, increasing the numbers of dealers and the touch points where we can increase the sales.
Understood, sir. All right, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Jaspreet Singh Arora from Equentis. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi. Rapan, congratulations, sir, and thanks for the opportunity. My first question is around that, you know, the previous participant also asked the so there are two things. One is, you know, leveraging from the Apollo group. So one is leveraging the brand, the distribution scale, etc., which we've done, and the other is related to the brand ambassador, which obviously you said Amitabh Bachchan. So I believe so far we've been, you know, not spending as much because we would have probably been using the indirect benefits of you know, Amitabh Bachchan being associated with the APL Apollo group. So going forward, did you mean that we would now have our own brand ambassador and therefore up our ad spend, or the earlier strategy of the last 2 or 3 years would continue? I'm not very sure what you meant there.
Yes, Mr. Jaspreet. Yeah, of course, we get the, you can say, leverage from the steel brand because the brand spending is much higher in the steel brand, and we get a leverage because of those spendings in the, you can say, in the market. But of course, and if we talk about Apollo, we are trying, you can say, looking for, you can tie up with some of the brand ambassadors, and which has been finalized, but because of the COVID, it was not, the shoot was delayed. So it will be coming into the picture by the end of, you can say, this quarter, and from the next quarter, we will be coming on air. So we will be having our own brand ambassador for Apollo Pipes, which will be seen in the, you can say, in the TVCs or the public hoardings. So it will definitely be, because of this thing, we have to increase our ad spend, and right now it is somewhere around 1 to 1.5%, which will be, you can say, going up to around 3% in the coming year.
Sure. Got it. And the other thing, sir, I believe April, you mentioned, is the last part of second half of April was slow because of restrictions.
Yeah.
So within geographies where we supply, right, and within segment, the two main segments, the building products and agri, which of them would have seen a higher dent? So if you could just geography-wise and segment-wise, to the extent that you have a color so far.
Actually, what is happening that some of the states in southern region as well as some of the states in northern regions, they are being affected by this COVID. Apart from that, in UP, if you talk about the elections, local elections, the panchayat elections were going on during the last month. So that was also hampering the demand of, you can say, the state. But of course, we were trying hard to sell our product in the last month also. But because of the strict lockdowns in the last few days of the month, so that has impacted. Otherwise, it was very much, you can say, within control of ours. And we were getting, you can say, regular orders from them. But right now, the things are very much in dark, and we are not clear that how the government will take steps into control the COVID and how and what by what time they can control it. So we are not very sure that how the things will move in this quarter. So as we move forward and the things will be clear, we will let you know that what exactly we are targeting for this quarter and in the current year.
So what I meant was like in same period last year, the agri was probably moving because of, you know, the focus, and, you know, rural was not impacted, the smaller towns was not impacted, while the building products was impacted. This time around, is it correct to say that both the segments are impacted because this time it's
I think you are right. Yeah, this time both the things are impacted because in this time, today's time, rural markets are also affected because of COVID. Last time it was not there; it was mainly into cities and the urban areas, and right now it is into the villages and, you can say, smaller areas also.
Okay. Got it, sir. That's all from my side. Thank you so much, and all the best.
Thank you.
Thank you. Participants, to ask a question, you may press star and one. The next question is from the line of Namit Mehta from KC Capital. Please go ahead.
Hello. Hi, sir. Congratulations on the great numbers. Just a couple of questions from my side. One on the distribution strategy. If you can just walk us through the value proposition that you have for your distributor, and also tell us a little bit about whether the focus is on capturing dealers from our competitors or more in terms of cultivating new dealers and distributors.
Of course, we talk about the distribution strategy. Right now, we are trying to give better services to our dealers. And apart from them, because of, you can see the brand is, you can say, not that big. The sales is not that big. The numbers are not that big. So the distributor get a better margin as compared to our other products, our competition in our product. So because of that thing, they are much more, you can say, inclined to sell our product in the market because of the less availability in the market. So secondly, if we talk about that, the support to the distribution sector, we are trying to market, market with them and increasing their, retail points and the, touch points. And our team is working with them to increase their market share. So in this case, we get sometimes we get the regular distributors. Apart from that, sometimes we also develop some of the steel or the other distributors into this product who are inclined to invest money into this business or increase their business. So both ways we are working hard. We are working with the existing dealers who are working in the same product with other brands, or we are also developing some new distributors also who are inclined to increase their business in this product.
Great, thanks. And another question with regards to the manufacturing network. So I realize that our plant network is more distributed across states, and that gives us more of a pan-India presence, whereas some of our competitors are more focused regionally and concentrated with larger plants in specific areas. Can you walk us through that strategy and what are the pros and cons there as well?
Of course, we get a benefit because of the our plants located all across the country in four different zones like east, west, north, and south. So we definitely get an edge because of this plant distribution, and our strategy is mainly to provide the material at the best rates to the distributors so that they can compete with the local markets or the local manufacturers that are there in their locality. And we definitely get an edge as compared to our distributors if they wish to sell a regional player is selling the product in any particular region, and we get us demand from all across the country, so that brand visibility is much higher as compared to any regional player who is available there. So because of these things, we get an advantage, and of course the lead time is also reduced because of the local presence of our manufacturing facilities at the different locations.
Great, thanks. And last question from my side, how are you seeing competitive intensity in the agri pipe space? You know, a couple of competitors have been weakened recently, so are you seeing any benefit there?
No, the competition is still there in agri pipes because of there are many unorganized players are also there in agri pipes. So the competition is still continuing at the same level. We don't see any kind of softening of competition in agri pipes, but we are much more focused towards building ports. So that is not our main focus area, but of course we are fighting the competition because of the competitors available all across the country, whether it's organized or unorganized. The agri pipe business is much more crowded as compared to this building ports.
Thank you and all the best.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Kashyap Zaveri from MK Investment Managers. Please go ahead.
Hello.
Yes, hello. Please go ahead with your question. Mr. Zaveri, please go ahead with your question.
Hello.
Yes, you are audible, sir.
Yeah, sure. Thank you so much for the opportunity. Two questions. The first one, I missed your conversation in between.
You're not audible. Can you be a bit clear, please?
Is this better?
Yes, far better now.
Yeah. What I'm saying is that I'm sounding a bit repetitive, but I missed your comments in the middle about expansion of the distribution channel. If you could repeat the numbers about what's the dealer network now and how many have we added in last 12-24 months. That's the first question. Second, I do understand that given the shortage of the PVC resins as well as the pricing of PVC resins, a lot of competition has moved out in regional spaces. But on a long term, this distribution channel plus the fact that you now have a nation a brand ambassador which nation associates with, in a longer term, how does this benefit once that competition probably comes back into the picture? These are the two questions I have.
But the question, your second question was not clear. Can you please repeat again, second question?
Hello.
Your second question was not very clear. Can you please repeat again?
Oh, sorry. So my second question was that I do understand that given the PVC resins, shortage as well as the, rising prices, a lot of competition has moved out of the market. But in a longer term, let's say when the prices stabilize and the supply does also stabilize, your distribution network plus, the spends that we are going to do on marketing, including a brand ambassador which the nation knows or associates with, in the long term, how do you expect that to help sustain the kind of numbers that we have today?
Of course. Thank you, sir. First of all, regarding the distribution network, we have increased, you can say, the distribution network by around 10-15% in the last, you can say, financial year, mainly in the last quarter, because first quarter was very much hit, and second quarter onwards, we started marketing the products, but because of the various limitations, we were not able to market very freely. So we are working hard in increasing the distributors, and apart from that, we have also increased the touch points by 20-25% in the current financial years by working hard with the various dealers, by increasing their sale points and increasing their reach in the nearby areas where they can sell the goods, and and making our retailers available at each and every point within their vicinity. So in that way, we are supporting our distributor network to increase the
sales.
What
is the number today? Exit number today?
If you talk about that touch points, or if you talk about this distributor network? Distribution network should be somewhere around, right now it is active distribution network should be around 300-400 distributors should be there. And apart from that, if you talk about a total, it should be around 500-600. But if you talk about the active, it should be around 300-400 active distributors are there working with us right now. And so secondly, if you talk about the resin prices, right now the resin prices are very high, and because of that thing, that is a major constraint for the smaller or the unorganized players to market their product in the, you can say, to market their product. And apart from that, resin shortage was also continuing. But that resin shortage was not there because of, you can say, lack of, you can say, this. Lack of ability to import it or buy from the regular sources, but the shortage was mainly because of their ability, low availability from the Reliance or the local manufacturer that were not, that were, those are not able to sell their product in the market. So because of that thing, the you can say smaller players or the online players were facing trouble. In the coming days, definitely they will try to increase their, you can say, footprints or the market share with the, you can say, lower margins or you can say in the market. But we are right now, those players, if you see that those players are mainly into the agriculture pipes only, and we are mainly focusing building products, which in which you don't see much of the players working with that, you can say, fittings or the other segments. So our market will not be going to be too much changed because of the change in the this raw material prices or the resin ability improves. We are not going to see too much challenge in marketing our product. And apart from that, if we associate our brand with some good brand ambassador, definitely we will get an edge on marketing our product, and definitely it will help in improving our market share in the coming time.
Sure. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Karan Bhatelia from Asian Market Securities. Please go ahead.
Hi, sir. Thank you for the opportunity.
Thank you.
Sir, now that the southward movement of the PVC resin prices have started, so how is the behavior of our dealer distributor? Are they stocking less of the inventory in the anticipation of the further downfall? Or how do you see things now?
Yeah, of course, the prices are going down, and dealers or the distributors, they are a bit cautious because of that down prices. But as the lockdown is also going on, so they also know that the product availability will also be a big challenge in the coming days, because the number of labors are not available at the ease in our works or any of the works in the country because of the COVID fear. So there is a bit of dilemma in the dealers or the distributors' mind that whether to keep the inventories or to reduce the inventories. Of course, because of the fear of the price drop, they are trying to work at the minimum inventory. But still, they are managing the minimum level of inventory with them so that they do not miss the, you can say, season opportunity if the market opens by the second half of the month or the, you can say, later in the month. So they wish to grab the opportunity. Apart from that, they don't want to face any loss because of that price drop. So they are, you can say, working in both ways. The products where the margins are good, they are keeping the inventory with them, and where the margins are low, they are trying to deplete the inventories.
Got it. And one more thing, we've like more than 1500 SKUs now. So what could be the number of SKUs for CPVC, if you can throw some color to it?
If you talk about we don't talk about CPVC alone. If you talk about the fitting segment, right now the fitting in the fitting segment, the SKUs is around 1000. You can say SKUs are there in the fitting segment alone.
Okay. Thanks for sharing. That's it for mine.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Rahul Agarwal from InCred Capital. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi, good afternoon. Am I audible?
Yes.
Thank you so much for taking my question. So I had 3-4 things. Firstly, I can see the company growing in the right direction, right? So as you said, the quality is the same. The distribution network effort and how the leaders have been doing it, you are doing the same thing. The regional plant locations are pretty much the same. You know, you're trying to get into east and south, which is you know, a weaker segment right now. You know, most of the players are trying to expand into eastern markets as well. In terms of SKUs, you know, you're trying to build up a lot of into fittings, tanks. So your product basket is great. You have CPVC, PVC both. You know, the earlier participant also asked ki what is price the proposition for the customer, and you said ki aisa nahi hai, you know, and we are basically offering them lot, you know, most of it what other leaders are offering. I'm trying to understand, sir, what is the right to win here? For Apollo Pipes, obviously, it comes very naturally that APL Apollo had a great presence in steel. You know, the business has done really well last 10 years, and hence it is a natural transition for you to grow into plastic pipes. But if you could just give me top 2 points for any, you know, for any new player in plastic pipe segment, you know, why they should be successful. If everybody can replicate what we are doing, even, you know, and put factories at four corners of the country, is that the only proposition we have? Obviously, you need the balance sheet for that. I understand that. But if you give me 2 points on that, please.
Yeah, of course, Mr. Rahul. First of all, if we see the brand, talk about the competition and see the Apollo brand is quite big as compared to the competition that is available in the market. The steel segment is very big, and we are selling somewhere around 2 lakh tons of steel pipes per month. So that definitely gives an edge to Apollo PVC segment to sell the product in the market, which is, of course, not available with maximum of the brands that are there in the market. The brand visibility or the brand, you can say, brand acceptability, that has to be there in the market, which is there available with the Apollo, and it is not there with each and every competition that are there in the market. Of course, some of the markets, you can say, players, they are working hard with their brand also, but seeing the, dual support from the steel segment, apart from that, we are also expanding on the branding activities of Apollo PVC segment. So we get a dual benefit because of the brand, between both the companies. So first of all, that benefit we get in marketing our product. Second of all, of course, it is very easy to put up a plant of PVC and across the country, and you can say that we can get a market share in the product of PVC by selling, increasing the product portfolio or increasing the, you can say, dealer or distributor. But it is not like that. Actually, we have to get our, you can say, distributors or the dealers or the, you can say, retailers have a belief in our brand, or they have to see that how exactly they see their business growing in our business. So if we make, instead of just the customer, if we make them our channel partner, or we make them part of the growth, So they are much more inclined towards, you can say, selling our product, and we are trying to focus in that thing only. We are trying to make our channel partners as a real partner in our growth, and they are also going along with Apollo. So they are much more inclined in increasing the product sales, and they are also increasing the profit margins because of that, you can say, increasing sales. So because of that thing only, we are trying to increase the sales. Apart from that, of course, the second thing is only there, that the brand visibility as compared to other competitors is there with us, which we definitely have an edge in selling our product.
Okay, got that. Second question was, so let's say today, if I have to compare any particular pipe segment, you know, whatever product you want to choose, what would be a price difference between Apollo Pipes versus a Supreme or Ashirwad or Aston? Whatever product you want to pick up, just broadly.
Yeah, it is roughly around 3-4%. You can say expensive than our product.
Okay, got it. Two small questions. CPVC capacity and revenue for fiscal 21 and fourth quarter. Could you share that, please?
We cannot share on the public forum, but of course it is increasing by around 30-40% annually. And this year we have again increased the volume by 30% and the value by 40% in the CPVC. And the fittings we have grown by around 40%. So that growth is there, but we cannot share because of the competitors. You can say this thing. We cannot share this on this platform. We can share this on email package.
Got it. And last question. So if I look at 5 years out from here, let's say 2025, 26, I understand your 23 plan. Will Apollo Pipes be similar to a plastic product company like what Supreme is doing, having presence across plastic products? Or in terms of your planning, you're working towards pipe right now, obviously, but directionally, where does this company go over 5-10 years? Like, will plastic pipes be the focus? Or you'll expand or diversify?
Yeah. We are actually trying to focus on the plastic products. It is not only plastic pipes. It may be various products, but we right now in Apollo Pipes, we are mainly focusing the plastic products only, and we are trying to increase our product share or the product basket or the capacities in this segment only. So down the years, we are not planning to add any other you can say material in our group. We are just trying to add the plastic products in this segment only.
So for example, Astral added adhesives. Will adhesives be a attractive opportunity, or you think you won't do it and you'll stick to plastic products?
Right now, we will stick to the plastic products. Right now, the adhesive that we are selling, it is mainly used with the plastic pipes only. So it is, and it is at a very small scale. So right now, we are not focusing too much on adhesives. Of course, it is a big business, and many other companies are running their whole company on the basis of adhesive only. But right now, our main focus is plastic and building products only.
Perfect. Thank you so much for answering my questions. All the best.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Arpit Shah from Stallion Asset. Please go ahead.
Yeah, thanks again. We wanted to know how our EBITDA per ton will be moving going ahead. If I just see the numbers for the last 2 years, it's been around 10,000 rupees EBITDA per ton. And this year, for the last two quarters, it has moved higher of 20,000. And if I see for some of the larger companies like, let's say, Supreme or an Astral, there have been an upwards of 35,000-40,000 per ton. So how do we see our EBITDA per ton moving?
Yeah, Mr. Arvind, actually, the EBITDA per ton is mainly depends upon the product basket that we sell. And the product basket of Supreme or Astral or Apollo, they are not, you can say, very much similar. They are similar, but not very same. So it changes from company to company depending upon the product mix that we are selling. Right, we are selling these taps and faucet that have a totally different type of EBITDA per ton, whereas the pipes have different type of EBITDA per ton and the fittings have different type of EBITDA per ton. So we are much more focused on the individual EBITDA instead of taking the company as a whole EBITDA per ton.
So broadly, if I look at the realization, it would be different for all three products, right? Be it fittings, be it the pipes, be it agri and all that. The difference would come in realization, not in EBITDA. So EBITDA should reflect something of a higher number.
Yeah, EBITDA changes from product to product. The taps or the faucets, the selling price of that product is somewhere around 500,000 per ton. If you talk about the solvents, it is around 300,000-400,000 per ton. Or if you talk about the CPVC, it is around 300-400. Or pipes, it is around 150-160. So it changes from product to product. So it is very difficult to focus on this thing. So we are much more focused on the individual products rather to taking the all products in one basket and calculating as a whole.
Okay. So I'm just comparing the pipe business. So if I just see, if you see the EBITDA per ton, even if I take, let's say, 50-60% of the volumes, it would still come around 20,000-22,000, right? That's for the last two quarters.
I could not get you. What exactly are the pipe business? What were you selling?
Yeah, if I just talk about the pipe business, the pipe business would be around 50-60% of volumes, right?
Yeah.
And if I just take those volumes and compare it to the revenue, the realization will be still on the lower side as compared to some of the other players in the market.
Of course, yeah, it is on the lower side as compared to, you can say, other ports that we are selling. But if you say that if you talk about the EBITDA margin of the pipe, it is somewhere around, you can say, 5-10% or 8-10%, you can say, rather, because of the season period, and you can say it changes from season to month to month because of that. But it is somewhere around 8-10% of the, you can say, total forward, you can say.
No, also like we mentioned on the call earlier, that the other players are having 3-4% extra margin than APL Apollo. That means there will be 3-4% increase in the realization for the other players. So that is also the factor here.
Got it. Just one last question is, if I just talk about your parent company, that is APL Apollo. So APL Apollo succeeded when they had lower cost of goods and a differentiated product line, which that's what helped them to become a leader in the market. So is there something that we are trying to do differently for Apollo Pipes, where we can actually not become a market leader, but expand the market and gain the advantage? What would be a competitive advantage against all the larger
players? Yeah, of course, again, we are trying to add some of the products in our product basket that can give an edge to market the port and give the Apollo Pipes a different standing as compared to our competitors. But right now, we are much more focused towards, you can say, increasing the volumes and as well as the, you can say, capacity utilizations of our company. Apart from that, if some of the ports we get add into our port basket that give us an you can say, differentiation with our competitors, we will definitely take the edge of that thing and increase, you can say, the brand presence or the, you can say, margins with the help of that port. But definitely, that will be in the coming, you can say, days, coming years, how things move and how we get such forward in our core basket.
So broadly, we are targeting a utilization of 80% by FY20. So that roughly translates to around 900-1,000 crores so by FY20. How confident are you on achieving that target?
We are quite, you can say, bullish regarding that on this target because we are getting good response from the market from the last two quarters. The brand acceptance is very good there, and the capacities that we have to add that has been added, and we have the capacity to supply the product in the market. So we are quite aggressive in achieving these targets.
And this will be coupled with margin expansion, right? So right around 14,
of course, will be there, but we are trying to maintain the same margin level. And first of all, we try to increase the market share.
So around 150-160 crores by FY23.
Maybe we can see, sir, what we don't know right now.
And what will be working capital cycle by FY23?
It should be less than 50 days, you can say, by the coming days, because we are not much more focused to increase the working capital cycle. So it should be maintained in the coming years.
Aren't we targeting like APL Apollo where we should move close to negative cash conversion?
We don't know because these are two different products. So I don't know how the product will behave in the coming days for plastic ports. Definitely, we would like to keep the working capital cycle at the minimum, whatever best we can do. And we are focused on that thing.
And since you just entered, let's say, the tank business or the solvent cement business, would you be looking to enter more new products or new opportunity, or would you like to scale up these businesses first and maybe new products by FY22 or FY22?
First of all, we will like to increase the, you can say, volumes for these business that we have already started in our port. So we will be scaling up these ports only. Later on, if we get an opportunity to add up any good product which has a good EBITDA margin or the good, you can say, sales potential, then we will see for that. But right now, we are much more focused for the current products only.
So the revenue contribution from these products will be somewhere around 20% by FY23?
Of course, sir. It will be somewhere around 20%.
Got it. Got it. Thank you. Good luck, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, that was the last question. I would now like to hand the conference over to the management for closing comments.
Yes, thank you all for the participation. I hope we have been able to answer all your questions satisfactorily. Should you need any further clarification or would like to know more about the company, please feel free to contact our team. Thank you once again for taking the time to join us on this call, and have a good day. And wish you all to remain safe. Thank you.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of Motilal Oswal Financial Services, that concludes this conference. Thank you for joining us, and you may now disconnect your lines.